वेलकम टू श्योर एकेडमी. दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस क्रैश कोर्स जेनेटिक्स एंड प्लांट ब्रीडिंग. विदाउट फर्दर वेस्टिंग आवर टाइम, लेट अस सी एंड अंडरस्टैंड द लेक्चर नंबर 1. प्री मेंडेलियन थीरीज. प्री मेंडेलियन थीरीज आर दोज थीरीज विच वर प्रपोज्ड बिफोर द मेंडल्स लॉ ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. सो बेसिकली दीज आर द थीरीज प्रपोज्ड बिफोर 1900. दे आर सिक्स थीरीज प्रपोज्ड बिफोर मेंडल प्रपोज्ड हिज थीरी. So they are number 1, preformation theory, number 2, theory of epigenesis, number 3, Lamarck's theory, number 4, pangenesis, number 5, germplasm theory, and number 6, mutation theory. So coming to the first one, preformation theory. It is also to be remembered as homunculus theory. It was proposed by J. Swammerdam in the year 1679. According to this theory, he says that the whole organism is formed by enlargement of single small miniature structure. He called this miniature structure as homunculus. Homunculus is a preformed individual in a sperm or egg. Now coming to the next theory, theory of epigenesis. Theory of epigenesis was proposed by K.W. Wolf. He stated that a structure like homunculus does not exist in either sperm or egg. According to him, the organized body is formed by the differentiation of the undifferentiated living substance after fertilization. So this idea was called theory of epigenesis. So here we can see the undifferentiated cells undergoes differentiation and develops into functional organs. Then the next theory, theory of acquired characters or Lamarck's theory. This was proposed by Lamarck and basically known as Lamarckism. According to this theory, modifications in the characters or traits in the plants or animals are influenced by the environmental changes, and these changes are transferred from one generation to another. He believed that the environmental changes directly affects in plants rather than indirectly in animals. So to explain this, he used the example of elongation of neck in giraffe. Coming to the next theory, that is pangenesis or Darwin's theory. Pangenesis was proposed by Darwin in the year 1858. He is also known for the theory of natural selection. He believed that the particles which are responsible for carrying genetic material from one generation to another generation are referred as pangenes. And he further stated that all these pangenes accumulates and forms gametes or germ cells which are responsible for formation of new species or new individual. Coming to the next theory, that is germplasm theory, was proposed by Weismann. According to Weismann, basically the blood of an individual is comprised of two types of tissues, that is somatoplasm and germplasm. Somatoplasm related to the vegetative characters and germplasm is related to genetical characters. He further stated that change in germplasm affects the progeny of the individual. Then the last theory, that is mutation theory. It was proposed by Bateson, and he believed that the main reason for the evolution is large discontinuous variations, which is termed as mutation by Hugo de Veyrys. To explain the mutation theory, he used the plant specimen called Oenothera lamarckiana. Guys, please see the description given below for the latest videos on GPB. I need your support, guys, to make this information available to all the students aspiring to get admission under the stream GPB. So please do like and especially share this to the maximum students and subscribe the channel for the latest lectures. Thank you for watching.